Yeah.
Here we are in London before the big semi-finals with Aki Uchida, the most known Japanese journalist.
I don't know,
but I knew.
Okay.
And so, Nishikori, he has to play Djokovic.
Yes.
He wasn't very lucky versus Djokovic this year, but he was the US Open. So what do you expect and what do you think your guy could do? Because I saw him pretty well. This week. I saw him playing really great and Monday didn't like the fact that he had to run a lot in the first set.
Yes. So Nishikori, he has played Djokovic this year, only in this year, 5 times already. And he lost kind of easily in the Australia Open, but he played really good against him in Madrid, and then he was playing really, really close match in Rome, which means, you know, getting closer, and he is on the way to find the solution to beat Djokovic. So I think this time he might have the best chance to beat Djokovic, because I think Kim likes this surface. This surface suits his playstyle, and Djokovic is not this time, of course, he's still very great player, but not as good as he used to be.
In the first 6 months of
yes.
the year. I mean, it's,
yeah.
he had a little let down in the second part, and that's why Mara is where he is, no? When you talk to Kei Nishikori, how is he outside of the tennis court? I mean, when you have a chance to interview him, is he, does he have a sense of humor? Can you describe something that not many people know?
So his personality, you mean?
Yeah.
Yeah, of course, you know, now it's really tough to interview him because he is a huge star in Japan.
Sure.
But he hasn't changed at all. I mean, he's
doesn't
really,
have a beginning?
No.
Okay.
He's not arrogant at all.
Okay.
He's always very reserved and he is very nice to everybody, even to press, to
sure.
us.
Which is not
yes.
normal.
Yeah, he has, he's not the very, you know, very, you know, funny. I shouldn't say. He's not the guy who
jokes.
Is making jokes a lot, but you know, during some conversation, he always tries to make some, you know, some unique comments or some jokes. So yeah, it's pretty fun to talk with him in Japanese, especially when he speaks in English. He might be a little bit nervous, but he can be funny in Japanese.
Just one quick question about his family. I mean, have you met his parents? Are they simple people? Did they change their attitude after their son became so famous and strong and famous?
I think that, you know, family, of course, they became more careful because now we, media, TV, camera are chasing them.
Chasing them all the time.
Yes, but I don't think basically they changed anything because they still live in a very countryside of Japan. They like to spend very normal life. So, yeah, I think it's, you know, nothing has changed a lot in the case of life and family.
And for Smash Magazine, did everything change a lot because of Nishikori? You sell 200,000 more copies than before?
Unfortunately, it didn't happen yet. But if he wins this tournament or some Grand Slams, yeah, I think that would happen in the future.
Okay, listen, thanks a lot
for
joining us. And best of luck to Kei, to Japan Tennis, and to Smash Magazine.
Thank you so much.